व्हाट एल्स? What else, tell me. So till what we have to say, sum of terms, right? Till what we have discussed, Arvind ji, Abhinav ji, Arvind, are you listening songs or listening to the class?
Class one, sir.
Yes. What till what you have learned? एकदम पूरा म्यूजिक म्यूजिक बना रहे हो, म्यूजिक डायरेक्टर बन जाओगे क्या? हाँ
Have
बताइए,
learned the difference and definitions of
थोड़ा
sequence and
जोर से बोलो
phase.
भाई, जोर से प्यार से बोलो।
Sir, we have learned the definition and the difference between sequence and phase. And then we
अभी
did
यहाँ
few
तन्वी,
examples, sir.
अंजलि,
In
कैम,
a, and
दिशा, एवरीवन। हाँ बताइए।
then we did some of terms and then.
अरे भाई थोड़ा जोर से बोलो, टॉक लाउडली।
And then we did some of terms.
यस बताइए तन्वी जी, आउट ऑफ द
सेम
सेम, ये नहीं बनता है, सेम कॉपी पेस्ट नहीं बनता है यहाँ पे। थोड़ा व्हाट एल्स वी हैव, व्हाट आर द थिंग्स वी हैव डिस्कस, वो थोड़ा बोलना पड़ता है। सेम सर, वो जो बोला है ये आंसर है। सो व्हाट एवर ही हैज टोल्ड, व्हाट एवर ही टोल्ड दैट इज द आंसर। सेम नहीं बोलना है। यस टेल मी तन्वी।
So at first we start with the sequence and like what are the difference between series and sequence, and then you gave us like few questions, and then and like and then you told us few concepts from 10th class also, and then all stuff.
खत्म खत्म। चलो ठीक है। सो सम ऑफ टर्म्स वी हैव लर्न, सो व्हाट एवर वी हैव लर्न यस्टरडे, सो दैट वाज टिल कहाँ तक, टिल व्हाट एवर वी हैव लर्न यस्टरडे क्लास, दैट वाज टिल यू नो 10th स्टैंडर्ड, 10th स्टैंडर्ड में जो भी पढ़ा था, सो दैट्स व्हाट वी हैव यू नो डिस्कस, इजंट इट? यस और नो? यस और नो? हाँ, नाउ विल स्टार्ट एक्चुअल पार्ट विच इज अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन। ठीक है, क्या करता है सीक्वेंस एंड सीरीज में, द फर्स्ट पार्ट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न विच इज अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन। सर वी हैव लर्न दैट वन ऑफ दोस इन 10th स्टैंडर्ड। यस सर, यू माइट हैव लर्न, यू माइट हैव लर्न, व्हाट इज यू, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन? दिशा प्लीज,
Sir, I don't know the exact definition of it.
so what do you remember from that?
If we are supposed to tell that a given sequence is in series, no, if a given series is in AP, so we need to subtract the second term and the first term, then we get a common difference, and that should be equal for all of them, for all the other numbers.
ओके, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय कॉमन डिफरेंस?
Sir, I don't know exactly how to
अरे
tell
यार,
that.
एवरीवन नोस हियर, एवरीवन नोस, आई एम नॉट आस्किंग यू व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय कॉमन डिफरेंस, नो वन नोस एग्जैक्ट डेफिनेशन हियर, सो नो वन नोस, तो किसको पता है फिर? कॉमन डिफरेंस मतलब व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम दैट, जो भी आपके आपकी अपनी भाषा में बोलो ना, यू टेल इन योर ओन लैंग्वेज, नो प्रॉब्लम, नो नीड ऑफ टेलिंग इन मैथमेटिकली, नो डेफिनेशन, आपको जो भी अंडरस्टूड हुआ वो बोल दो बस। यस अदिति प्लीज।
The difference between any two numbers
एनी टू नंबर्स, कोई भी टू नंबर्स ले लो, कोई भी टू, एनी टू नंबर्स आर टू,
from the
सीक्वेंस
difference
है,
between
फ्रॉम
two
द सीक्वेंस,
consecutive numbers.
टू डिफरेंस बिटवीन टू कंसेक्यूटिव नंबर्स, एनी टू नंबर्स इज रॉन्ग हियर, टू कंसेक्यूटिव नंबर बोलना है, जो बैक टू बैक नंबर, राइट? हाँ अमृत, यस प्लीज अमृत, टेल मी व्हाट इज सम ऑफ एन नेचुरल नंबर्स फॉर्मूला यू हैव लर्न फ्रॉम 10th स्टैंडर्ड, कम ऑन बेटा।
Sir, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into
ये कहां से आ गया, सम ऑफ फर्स्ट एन नेचुरल नंबर फॉर्मूला, दैट इज एन एंथ टर्म, राइट?
I know, sir. So, if we need to find the fifth term, then we will do a plus 4d.
No, that is, I'm not asking for that, that is there, I'm just talking about if I ask you to solve the fifth term or sixth term, then you have to find out that, you know, you have to use that formula. I'm asking you, right? So if I give five numbers, if I give five numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I can add it easily. If I give 100 numbers, how could I add it? What is the formula for that?
We will use SN formula, sir.
Tell me, Anjali. You are raising your hand, right?
Yes, sir. N by 2 times 2a plus n minus 1b.
That is there. And one more formula we have learned.
N by 2a plus l. So, yeah. N by 2, 2a plus l.
That is also
l.
There. That is also there. One more formula. Sum of n so natural numbers. For finding sum of first n natural numbers. Yes, Aditi.
Is it 2a plus l?
2a plus l. No. Abhinaya?
Sir.
Bata hai, Abhinaya.
Sir, n into n plus 1 into 2.
N into n plus 1 into 2 nahi hota. N into n plus 1 by 2 hota. All right. So, sum of n natural number is what? N into n plus 1 by 2. Sum of squares of first n natural number is what, Disha?
Sir, can you repeat?
Sum of squares of first n natural numbers.
I don't know, sir.
No problem. Chalo. So that is n into
N plus 1 by 2.
For everything is same formula. For finding sum of first n natural numbers, n into n plus 1 by 2. For finding sum of squares of first n natural numbers? Hello. I give already hint. Hello. N plus 1 into 2n plus 1 divided by n. 6. Sum of cubes of first n natural numbers is what? N into n plus 1 by 3 whole square. All right. Yes, sir, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Everyone turn your camera. Let us get into the class. Let us get into the class now. So today let us discuss about arithmetic progression. Arithmetic progression, okay? In arithmetic progression, guys, you write a sequence is called AP. What is that? AP, arithmetic progression. If the difference between consecutive terms is constant. All right, so what is that? Tn minus Tn minus 1. Supposed to be what? Constant. That's supposed to be constant. And this also can be written as what? D, which means common difference. Common difference is what? Difference of two consecutive terms supposed to be कांस्टेंट फॉर ऑल एन बिलोंग्स टू नेचुरल नंबर्स, सबसे नहीं होगा, नेचुरल नंबर से ही होगा. ऑलराइट, यस. नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट वन एग्जांपल. इफ आई टॉक अबाउट वन एग्जांपल, सिंपल, हियर 1, 3, 5, 7, --. सो हियर nth टर्म ऑफ एपी इज व्हाट हियर pn. I do not know the term. Nth term means I do not know. This is, look at this here. This is my T1. This is T2, T3, T4. So like that, I have so many terms which till n. So then Tn. All right. Look at this here. Here the common difference. Here the common difference, here the common difference. Common difference is equal to d, and come on, first term, always first term is going to be always denoted by what? A. Common term denoted by, common difference denoted by d, first term denoted by a. All right, chalo. Now here I know the formula. I know the formula. What is that formula? Is, look at this. Nth term is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Always you write this, everyone. So nth term of the general, nth term of the arithmetic progression is what? Nth term of the arithmetic progression is what? A plus n minus 1 d. What is a here? You write where? You write where here? Where the common difference. Now write the solution. Now solution is what? Here a is equal to what? 1. D is equal to what? 3 minus 1, which means 2. Are you understand, children? A is equal to term 1, first term is equal to 1. D is equal to what? Second term minus first term is what? 3 minus 1, which gives me 2. All right, so nth term is what here? Therefore nth term is equal to tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. What is a here? 1 plus n is what here? What is n here? This is nth term, right? And let me find out the first term. Look at this here. He has given here simple 1, 2, 1, 3, 5, 7. Where he has given 1, 3, 5, 7 series. So here I'm just showing you that what is a here. A is first term. D is what? Second term minus first term. What is nth term? This is nth term. How? Look at this. If you calculate vice versa, look at this. If you keep calculating this one. So T1. How I'm going to get T1? T1 can be written as, if I write T1 in place of n, I know the Tn formula is what? A plus n minus 1 d, right? So T1 means T1 is equal to, A is what here? A is what? A plus n is what here? N is what? N. I'm finding first term, right? What is n here? 1. So 1 minus 1. So T1 is equal to A. Means first term is what? A. First term is what? A. All right, second term. Now let us find second term. T2 is equal to what? A plus 2 minus 1 D. So T2 is equal to what here? A plus D. What is T3 here? T3 is equal to A plus 3 minus 1 D, which means A plus 2 D. This is T3. All right. So basically for identifying an arithmetic progression, what exactly the rule is? The rule is the term supposed to be a plus d, a plus 2d, a plus 3d, a plus 4d. and dash 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 like this. En is equal to a plus d. All right, it goes on like that. A plus n minus n d like that. Clear? All right, children. You understand? For identifying any arithmetic progression, what is the sequence actually? What is the series? First term is a. Second term is a plus d. Third term is a plus 2d. Fourth term a plus 4d, and goes on like that. Clear? Third term is a plus 4d. Fifth term is a plus 5d. It goes on like that. You understand? Yes or no? A plus d, a plus 2d, a plus 3d, a plus 4d. Now look at this here, sir. Why you wrote 1, 3, 5, 7 here, and why you are telling T1 is A and T2 is A plus D, T3 is A plus 2D. Clear? Now, guys, let me find out whether I'm getting T1 as 1 or not. What is my T1 here? From the given question, what is my T1? This is my T1. This is my T2. This is my T3. This is my T4. T4 means fourth term. T3 means third term. I'm representing with the T3. All right. So now let us check whether we are getting that. Let us check whether we are getting 1, 3, 5, 7 series or not. Look at this here. So T1 is what here? A, right? A is equal to what here now? T1 is equal to A. 1. A means what? First term. A is what? First term. So A plus D. Look at this here. A plus D. A is what I got? 1 plus D. How much here? 2. So 1 plus 3. 1 plus 2. How much? 3. 3 I got or not? Look at this. 1 I got. 3 I got. So third term is what here? A is 1. 2 into D is what? 2. So 2 plus 2. 2 into 2. 4. 4 plus 1. 5. So 5. Look at this. 5 we got or not? So like this we are getting everything. All right. We are getting like this. Clear, children? Any doubt here? Any doubt here? Mm-hmm. Any doubts? How we are getting the terms? I just proved you now. The basic identification. How do we need to identify whether it is an AP series or not? The term is supposed to be like this. A plus D, A plus 2D. All right. And that is the basic idea. There is a, you know, technically that is a correct. But if I ask you to find out, you have to just check difference between two consecutive terms is constant or not. That is what you have to check. Look at this here. Let me check here. Let me check by giving one more example. See here, let me read one example. Check whether three, comma, 5, comma, 7, comma, 9, comma, 11, comma, 13, comma, 15 are in an AP or not. It is in an AP series or not. Are in an arithmetic progression or not. Let us check. Look at this by using common sense. Look at this difference between these two terms is how much? 2. Difference how much? 2. 2. 2. 2. 2. Everywhere we have 2. So it is yes. Yes. It's in AP. Yes, it is in AP means it is in arithmetic progression. Yes, it is in arithmetic progression series. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes. This is how we can give the answer quickly. Look at this. What is A here? Here, what is A here? 3. A is what? What is A? A is what here? T1. First term, 3. What is D here? Common difference. How much? T2 minus T1. Second term minus first term, you have to do all this. How much? 5 minus 3 gives me 2. Or D can be also written 3 minus T2, which is also 7 minus 5. So look at this again. So D also can be written as T4 minus T3. T4 is what? 9 minus 7. Clear? So this is how you can just simply do this. Alright. So D everywhere I'm getting 2, 2, 2, 2. So no need of writing every D is here. No need of writing all Ds. Write only one D. You can write whatever you can write however you want. All right, any doubts? Now look at this here. First term is A, I told you. Second term is what? First term is how is supposed to be? First term is A. Second term is A plus D. Third term is what? A plus 2D. a plus 3d. Now check it out. Check it out. This is my first term, right? So a is what here? 3. Second term is what? A plus d, right? A plus d means 3 plus d is what? 2. So 5. So say third term is what? 3 into 2, which means 7. Fourth term is what? 3 plus 3 into 2. So it means 9. Look at this now. Check whether we are getting same answer or not. 3, 5, 7, 9. So which means what? The order of AP series supposed to be like this. A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D, A plus 4D, and goes on. Clear? Yes or no? Therefore, clearly, the given sequence is in an AP. Clear? Any doubts?
No, sir.
Very simple. Understood, guys? Now, what is the general formula of AP? What is the general formula of AP? Tell me. A plus N minus 1 D. What is A here? First term. D is what? Common difference. What is common difference? T2 minus T1. Second term minus first term. Or third term minus second term. Or fourth term minus third term. Or fifth minus fourth. Or sixth minus fifth term. You could write however you want. But difference between two terms supposed to be constant. Which is common difference. Which is what? Common difference. Arithmetic progression means what? Difference between two consecutive terms supposed to be constant. That is what arithmetic progression. Common difference is what? Whatever the term, two terms you take, that is supposed to be constant. That is also same thing. All right. That is also same thing. Clear? Understood, guys? Understood? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now we'll talk about the general expression. General expression for sum of terms. General expression for nth term, what I told you now. So you just write here. If you want, you can write. So note. Nth term of an arithmetic progression. Tn is equal to what? A plus n minus 1 d. Is what? Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 d. Clear, children? So make a note of this. Yes or no? Clear? So that is a nth term. So this is what now we are going to write general expression for sum of terms. Simply let me write your formula. No need of writing everything. Simply Sn. Sn means what? Sum of n terms. S means sum of what? N terms. Sn means what? Sum of n terms. Sum of n terms. N terms, which denoted by Sn, is equal to n by 2 a plus n minus 1 d. Look at this now. N by 2, as it is, I'm writing a is what here? First term. What is this one? Nth term or last term. You write nth term. Clear? Nth term, isn't it? We do not know what is the last term. So we can write first term plus last term by 2. N into first term plus last term by 2 also correct. So now can I simply write this? Can I simplify this one? Can I simplify this? Is equal to N by 2 into A plus A is 2A plus N minus 1. This is the formula for sum of Sn formula. This is sum of N term. Clear? Any doubts? All right.
Yes.
So this is for all n belongs to n, right? For all n belongs to n only. For all n belongs to n, n means what? Only natural numbers are possible. N cannot be anything here. N is for only natural. Look at this here. And or this can be written as Sn is equal to what? N by 2 plus A, please what? First term. T1 means first term plus nth term, last term. Clear? This is also correct. All right, beta. Understand? You understand or not?
Understood.
Yes, sir.
Chalo. Very simple now. Let us solve the question. So let us write a few facts. Let us write a few facts. What are the facts? What we have learned? Facts. What are the facts we are going to learn? Look at this. First fact is what? If a fixed number is added to each term of a given AP, then the resulting sequence is also an AP. The same common All right, Veda, look at this here. So if a fixed number is added to each term of a given term, given AP, the resulting sequence is also what? AP only. Which means, look at this here. Let me give an example. Look at this here. For suppose, let us take 5, 7, 9, 11, 13... All right. He has given that is in AP. Okay. So now look at this here. Now I'm adding fixed number, any number. You take one or two, anything. Let me add. Adding two each number given in series. So look, if I add each number to look at this here, 5 plus 2, 7 plus 2, 9 plus 2, 11 plus 2, what I'm going to get, tell me?
7, 9, 11, 13, 15
plus 2. If you add plus 2 to everyone, what I'm going to get, tell me? 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. Like that. Look at this. Again, this series also. This is a resultant series. This is a given series. This is a resultant. Resultant series. All right. Resultant series also AP or not. Look at this now. Common difference is 2. Everywhere 2 only. So, it is also in AP. It is also in AP. Clear? Any doubts? All right. This is,
yes, sir.
You write resultant series. Write this as resultant. Resulting sequence, right? All right. Any doubts? So what is the fact one? If I add a fixed number to a given sequence, so after adding whatever the resultant series sequence I get, that will be also in what? AP only. With what common difference will be also same? With the same common difference. There is no change in common difference. Are you getting my point? Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, next. Next fact. Next fact. If each term of an AP is multiplied by a fixed number multiply or divide, you write anything. Multiply, yeah, divide. Multiplied or divided by a fixed number, fixed non-zero number. Fixed कौन सा zero number? Fixed non-zero number. Number, you should not write fixed number here. You should write fixed non-zero number. Zero is also number, right? You should not multiply with a zero. If you got zero, everywhere zero only. So there is a no point of that. Okay. The resulting sequence is also an AP only with a common difference multiplied by Q. All right, let us say example. Series, I say sequence. I have a sequence, let me write here. Three, seven, 11, 15, 19, 23, and goes on. All right. So now what I'm doing is adding, multiplying each term. Multiplying each term by 2, let us say, and dividing each term. You just multiply first, let us see. Multiply, what is the resultant series? Resultant sequence is going to be what? Resultant sequence is going to be what? If I multiply the two, what I'm going to get?
6, 14, 22, 30, like that.
Look at this. So 6, 14, 22, 30, 38, 46. Look at this. Now the resultant sequence, whether it is in AP or not. The common difference is what here? 8. Common difference is 8. comma difference is 8, 8, 8. All right, so this is a comma difference. So resultant sequence is what? 8, 8, 8, 8, 8. So resultant sequence we got with a comma difference called 8. So now even I multiply and you take anything. If you divide also, whatever the resultant you get, whatever the resultant sequence you get, that also definitely it will be in AP only. All right. All right. Therefore, the resultant sequence is also in an AP. Clear? Any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. Next. Third fact. If A1, comma A2, comma A3, --, and B1, comma B2, comma B3, --, are two APs, two arithmetic progressions. Two AP, matlab, don't get confused, guys. Two APs, matlab, these are two arithmetic progressions with a common difference D. And let us say D-. Okay, common difference of this is D, and common difference of this is what? D-. I'm just denoting like that. Clear? Respectively, then A1 plus B1. I mean, first term of this series and first term of this series. A1 plus B1. A2 plus B2. A3 plus B3. --, is also an arithmetic progression. All right, it is also an arithmetic. See, the first term of the first sequence and second, so first term of the second sequence, if you add all these, it's also going to be an AP, isn't it? AP with a common difference D plus D-. What is that with the D plus D-? All right. So A1, A2, A3, and B1, B2, B3 are two arithmetic progressions with a common difference D and D-, respectively. Then A1 plus B1, comma A2 plus B2, comma A3 plus B3 is also in an AP. Is also an AP. Clear, children? Any doubts?
No, sir.
Now, last fact, we'll write. Last fact. So sum of what? Sum of the terms equidistant from the beginning. From the beginning and end is always same and is equal to the sum of first and last term. Getting my point? See here, sum up. Try to understand what we are writing in a simple language. Try to understand it clear cut, right? Try to understand it clear cut. Try to understand it a crystal clear cut way. Understand? If you are not understanding anything, please ask me, guys. Sum of the terms equidistant from the beginning and end is always same and equal to the sum of the first and last term. Sum of the terms equidistant from the beginning and end. From the first term and the last term, whatever the sum of these, look at the sum of the equidistance. If you have same equal distance between two terms, if you add those two terms from the beginning and end, is always same and equal to the sum of the first and last term. Is always equal to the first and last term. Let me write here. Example. If A1, A2, A3, dash till AN. We didn't write example for the third rule, right? Or fact, no problem. So understand that easily. R in arithmetic progression, then A1 plus AN is equal to A2 plus AN minus 1 is equal to A3 plus AN minus 2 is equal to dash, so on. Assumption. Yeah, look at this here. A1 plus AN, first term plus last term is equal to second term plus this term, second last term. You understand, children, what I meant to say here? First term from the first. The first term from the last is equal to sum of the first term from the first and first term from the last is equal to sum of the second term from the first, second term from the last is equal to equal. You understand? So let me write an example here. If you are not understanding this, one more example, let me give this. First of all, 1, 3, 5, 7. Yeah, sorry, 9. That's you have. Look at this here. So 1 plus first term plus last term is what here? T1. I'm writing A1 plus. Well, how many terms I have? Five terms, right? So T1 is what here? 1. T5 is what here? 9. So sum of these two, how much? 10. All right. So T1 is the first term from the first. T5 is the first term from the last. So this is the one thing. So second thing is what? These two will be equal. Or else you do one thing here. Let us write one more thing. All right. See here. Now, this one and this one. Sum of these two terms. So will be 11, this will be 12. So sum of second term, this one and this one. Look at this. Sum of the T2 and T2 is 3 here. T4, so T6 here, right? This is T5. This is T5. 1, 9. So look at this here. This is also 12. Now third one is what? T3 is what? 5. T4 is what? 7. Yes. Sum of these two, how much? 12 now. Look at this. Everywhere I'm getting 12 only. So what I understood from this? Sum of the first, last terms will be equal to sum of these two terms. And these two terms. Alright. So, dekho, this one plus this one plus this one, third plus third, third from the first, third from the last, second from the first, second from the last, first from the first, second from the first from the last. All right, first from the first plus first from the last, second from the first plus second from the last. and third from the first plus third from the last. So this will be, sum of these two will be equal. All right. So look at this here. What I meant to say here, let me, you just understand with this blue color circles and the red colors are, these two red colors are matching here. This blue color, sum of these two will be clear. So you just understand in this way. Clear, children? Any doubt? Any doubt now? Yes. Any doubt? Is it clear with everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, just let us stop here itself now. So let's retire now. Oh, please refer these notes and come to the next class.
Sir. Okay, sir.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Yes, tell me, make it fast.
Sir, tomorrow you are keeping test, right, sir?
Yes.
Sir, actually we have a test from college also, sir, from morning 10 to evening 6, sir.